Hello and welcome back in the 6th episode of The Evolution of Virtue. Today I will talk about sex. Probably not the one that you are thinking. As you may remember, Virpu now can moose around in this green habitat, takes food from the trees, makes friends, but there is a thing that he cannot do. Reproduce itself. For this reason, it's time to introduce Vulpina. A little creature similar to Virpu, but female. To celebrate this occasion, I totally changed the animation of the movement. Here you can see in Unity Virpu and Vulpina side by side. She is a bit bigger and slightly redder of the male counterpart. To check the animation system, I create a simple animator with two states, the movement and the static one. The transition between those two happens if the variable is moving, is activated or deactivated. During the test, to activate the transition, it was simple enough to press the spacebar. Later on, Virpu will take this decision. Now I press one time, now I press again. Beautiful. I just realized that Virpu and Vulpina skins are so similar that it is impossible to distinguish them from a certain distance. It's time to return to Blender. I'm very proud of these results. Let's now insert the new creature in the simulation. What the fuck? They just become Michael Jackson. Now it's better. After I play the simulation for 1 minute, strange things start to happen to the creature. They don't jump properly anymore and their ears begin to collapse. This is due to object pull. Object pull is a technique used when there are a lot of objects on screen that can spawn on the spawn frequently. It works in this way. Instead of deleting a Virpu when it dies, you make its game object invisible to the camera. Then, when you want a new creature to burn, you just need to reactivate the game object of an old creature and relocate it in the new position. In this way, you speed up a lot the process. The problem with object pull is that if you don't restart properly all the features of the game object, you introduce bugs. The funny part of solving problems in Unity, but in general in programming, is that when you thought to have fixed all the bugs, you have not.
2,000 years later.
Since the status quo is restored, I can proceed to program the reproduce system. First of all, I need an animation to play when Virpu and Vulpina reproduce. Nothing dirty, just a simple movement to understand that soon they will become parents. Look, it's us! She's twerking! Since my fantasy skills are still under development, I just copied the Vulpina twerking style on Virpu. Second of all, I must upgrade the target system. In the brain of the creature there are two goals. Search for food to not die and reproduce in order to preserve the species. If Virpu has more than half of its life, then it starts searching for a partner. Otherwise, it focuses its attention on food. Once a target is allocated, everything works like in the last episode. The angular velocity of the creature is changed in order to orientate Virpu towards the target. If the food target is reached, Virpu eats it. If the partner is reached, the party will begin. The next step is creating a growing animation. When a creature is born, it's a baby. This means it can't target anything because it doesn't understand the world yet, and it loses just a quarter of life every frame. When the creature is mature, then it starts losing more life and following the target system. These are the rules of the game up to this moment. It's time to play What Will Happen. I give you 10 seconds to understand if the population go extinct, grow indefinitely, or something else. The answer is, it depends. Since a lot of processes happen randomly, the simulation can start just with all Vilpu or all Vulpina, and so for sure the population will go extinct. But many times the creatures increase the population until an equilibrium with the habitat is reached. This is exactly the logistic growth of animals in real life. The fact that we can reproduce it with just a very simple code, it's awesome. But what will happen if we introduce a predator? You will discover it in the next episode. I hope you liked this video. Next one will be even better. See you next time.